Longer for Calgary Cross.
Thank you very much, Madam Speaker. Let me continue the ongoing tradition, albeit a little later than some, on congratulating you to being elected to the position of Deputy Speaker. And let me also take this opportunity through you to congratulate all of the members of this Honourable Assembly on their recent election success. I truly look forward to having many positive debates about the issues that Albertans face in the coming years with each and every member in this House. Madam Speaker, today is the first opportunity for me to rise before this Assembly and second the speech from the throne. It is a real honour to stand before you this afternoon because I join a government that has the vision, the plan, and the clearest mandate in recent history to take Alberta to unprecedented levels in the coming years. First and foremost, it is with the sincerest gratitude that I thank the residents of Calgary Cross for placing their faith in this government and for electing me to my first term as the member of the Legislative Assembly for the 30th session. As I mentioned during my campaign many times, this seat belongs only to those residents, and I am committed and devoted to bringing their concerns to this government over the next 4 years. I'd like to take this opportunity as well to thank my extended family, my parents, my wife, and my children, and the many supporters who worked tirelessly and who exhibited an incredible level of patience with me during this past campaign. Madam Speaker, let me begin by telling you a little bit about the Calgary Cross constituency. Calgary Cross consists of the communities of Marlborough, Marlborough Park, Rundle, Pine Ridge, and Monterey Park, and it is located in the northeast quadrant of Calgary, where more than 50,000 people call home. It is, without a doubt in my mind, one of the most diverse constituencies in the province, both religiously and ethnically, and has one of the largest immigrant populations of any riding in the province. In fact, Mr. Speaker, more than half of the Calgary Cross constituency identifies with a visible minority group. I am tremendously proud to be the elected representative of this constituency. And I would encourage every member to visit Calgary Cross, where the food is as unique as it is phenomenal, and the people are warm, hardworking, and generous. Mr. Speaker, it is truly hard to imagine what my parents envisioned when they immigrated to Canada from Lebanon, a very small country in the Middle East in the 1970s. Along with millions of other newcomers, my parents mustered up the courage to pick up and leave the only country that they ever knew, the only language they knew, the only political system they knew, the only society they knew, and to move to a country which seemed to be worlds away. And they did it for one simple reason. They knew they wanted to seek a better life for themselves and for their children. And so, as cliched as the story goes, Mr. Speaker, with almost no money and no idea of what to expect, they embarked upon a move to Canada and settled first in Edmonton, Alberta, where they worked hard, and they ultimately moved to Calgary, where they raised 5 children in the East Calgary, where we called home. It is no secret to most people in this assembly as to where this story goes from here. Like all newcomers, through hard work and perseverance, my parents made Alberta their home. As many of you know, Mr. Speaker, I am very, very proud to tell you and the rest of the members of this assembly through you that my father sat in this very chamber for more than 22 years, where he was part of a team that helped Alberta become the economic envy of North America and, in fact, the entire world. Calgary Cross is, by geographical accounts, a small constituency, but it is a great constituency. We have had the honour and the privilege of being represented by many great MLAs. I am both honoured and privileged to be the MLA for the communities which were once served by my father, MLA Amory Sr., and the late Minister Buller, whose memory and legacy remains strong, and whose tragic and untimely death was a terrible loss for our province. The late Minister Buller was a dear friend to me. We traveled together, we went to university together, and we worked on various political campaigns together. And he is dearly missed by all of us. I have no doubt in my mind that I have tremendous shoes to fill, but I also have no doubt in my mind that I have the best political advisor in this province. Mr. Speaker, because of the hard work of my parents and the advantages that this province gave to us, I was able to attend university, where after many years, I graduated with a law degree in 2010, and I opened up a small law office in East Calgary. It is also because of my upbringing, my work in the community, and my involvement that I became motivated to run in the Calgary Cross constituency. In recent years, Mr. Speaker, I saw the economic prosperity of this province declining. Our small office started to see fewer real estate transactions, fewer new business startups, and fewer commercial transactions. Instead, more family issues, more foreclosures, more bankruptcies, and more disputes between neighbors. We began to see less of the work that signaled economic prosperity, and more of the types of work that indicated a troubling decline in productivity. It is also because of these remarkable changes that I observed in my own work that I started to look for answers. I found those answers in the policies of this current government. During the election, this government made a promise to Alberta to get them back to work. And I am proud to report, Mr. Speaker, that within a few weeks, this government has introduced four bills which are designed to energize our economy and simply get Albertans back to work. The first of those, the Carbon Tax Repeal Act, was a core promise during the campaign and the first bill introduced before this assembly. If passed, it will remove a debilitating consumption tax which has targeted families and businesses indiscriminately alike, without addressing the very environmental concerns that it was perpetrated to do. It was, in my view, the single greatest concern for Albertans as I campaigned from door to door. The next bill, the Open for Business Act, Mr. Speaker, is one that I am truly proud to support and advocate for, because this bill will alleviate some of the greatest challenges that the job creators of this province have been struggling with since changes were made by the previous government. I campaigned on the promise that our government would foster and support economic initiatives, and I am fully in support of this bill and the changes it will provide if it is enacted into law. Mr. Speaker, the vast majority of Albertans either operate a business or work for one. And as a government, it is simply incumbent upon us to do everything within our power to ensure their success. Next, Bill 3, the Job Creation Tax Cut. Again, Mr. Speaker, we campaigned on one simple philosophy, that our role as government would be to support and promote those who employed Albertans. Recently, the Honourable Minister of Culture, Multiculturalism and Status of Women said that Alberta was once the gold standard of economic development in this country. And Mr. Speaker, I genuinely believe that with this bill, it will once again make Alberta the gold standard for investment, both foreign and domestic. Finally, the Red Tape Reduction Act, Bill 4, was our government's promise to encourage Albertans to invest in this province, to take risks, and to make choices for economic success without worrying about bureaucratic barriers, delays, and costs. With this bill, we will send a message to all Albertans that this government is ready to embrace and encourage their ideas without burdening them with unnecessary challenges. Many of the stories that you've heard from my colleagues in their own maiden speeches are not unique. Albertans across the province were universally concerned about the previous government's policies. It was obvious that Albertans were struggling. They were concerned about the reports of unprecedented job losses and the unemployment rates that we were all witnessing. They were concerned about uncontrollable spending and the ballooning provincial debt. They were concerned about the assault on our natural resource industry. And they were concerned about the former policies which were designed to create barriers, not support, for Albertans looking to raise a family or start a business. And so I say to the business owner in Marlborough who told me at his door that he was struggling to keep his small trucking business afloat, help is on the way. And to the woman in Monterey Park who took my wife and I in during the storm that we had during the campaign and told us how she had lost her job more than a year and a half ago in the oil industry, help is on the way. And to the thousands of Calgary Cross residents and the millions of Albertans who have struggled to find work, to pay their bills, to keep a roof over their heads, and to keep their businesses afloat, help is on the way. On April 16, 2019, Mr. Speaker, Albertans spoke loud and clear. They gave us an unprecedented mandate for the next 4 years. And in less than 1 month in this assembly, we have introduced four bills that were designed to do exactly what we said we would do. Promises made, promises kept. Thank you very much.